Hi everyone. This talk will be in English, so I have the honor to present Khyati. Khyati started her career with WordPress 5 years back, and ever since she's been in love with it. She has an experience of 4 years as a plugin tester and is currently working as a happiness engineer with Automatic. And she's a people's person, and people like her company immediately as they see her. And recently I found out that her name, Khyati, means being famous. So pay attention to it. And she's been mentoring everyone around open-heartedly. And apart from her career, she enjoys the company of her family and travels as much as she can. Khyati will be talking about different tips and tricks which will help your WordPress website SEO. She'll walk you through some tools that you can use for more powerful websites. The talk will also include some nice methods for digital marketing. So, everyone, Khyati.
Thank you so much. Hello, everyone. Hola. Perfect. So, it's in bits of pieces I know of Spanish. Don't understand much of it. I'm trying my best to understand here. Okay, thank you. About myself, she did a great job introducing myself a bit here. As she said, I have been working with WordPress for about 5 years now, and I've been loving it so far very much. About today's talk, I'm talking about SEO, which is a crucial part for a website and its owner to make sure the site is, you know, seen by the public in a good way, have a good ranking as well. Because for every website or even a business, it's very important to get business, and SEO is one of the ways you can get more business out of it, okay? Okay, so starting with important aspects of SEO is the title. So here, basically, what we'll be covering is a few things that you need to make sure to follow so that your website can have a good SEO ratings, okay? So a few aspects here would be title of your page or a post. Then tags. Tags come very handy. They can be used as keywords. Now, what keywords means is the search engine searches your website using the words that you put to search, right? So whenever you go to Google and search for maybe WordPress hosting, it will search the websites or the pages that has tags using those words. So those are called keywords. So whenever you add tags to your post or pages, search engines make sure to search for those terms added to your post or pages and show your website or the page in the search results. So again, adding tags as well as meta. Meta is again a description to your post or page. A meta can also be a description to your website as well, okay? Now, for a website meta, you describe what is your website about, okay, in a few lines. And those descriptions should also include the terms that you write about. Be more specific in these descriptions so that the more specific you add your description, it would be easier for the end user to find your website while they search for it. So something like a website is about cooking recipes maybe. So just don't write a description like yummy food. Be specific, like if you're writing about Spanish cuisine, write more of Spanish cookery or of those terms. So be down to specificity. Next would be links. Again, links can be very useful for your website as well as SEO. What links would do is make sure, so always a search engine likes a website which has multiple links. So from a page A to page B, you add a link to it. So if you have those links, it will help search engines, bots, to understand your pages are linked well and are getting famous. As well as if a visitor visits your page or a site and sees a link to it and clicks on the link and goes to another page, that will let the search engine know your website is famous and being, you know, searched and visited by multiple users. That way, so multiple views can help the search engine to show, okay, this particular website is being clicked and visited quite often. That will help to make your website listed higher in the search result. So adding links again is a very good way to make sure of that. Page speed. Again, page speed should be taken care of very well when you design your website. Why is that? So if at all you have number of images on your homepage itself, which are very huge, say like 20 MBs of total image size is there on your website. Understand this perspective when a user lands on your page, on your homepage, and has to wait for a few minutes for the page to load. Would any one of us be happy to wait to just see a site? No, right? So always make sure your page, any of the pages, not just your homepage, is optimized so that the page speed is good enough and loads within a few seconds. I wouldn't say should load in 1 second. It's not realistic. So few seconds and the page should be loaded completely. All the text as well as images, sliders, whatever you add on your website should be loaded within that. So page speed again helps your search engines to show your site in a good, have a good rating basically. Okay, sitemaps. Sitemaps can be again helpful for the search engines to show where exactly you are landing. Okay, so maybe you first go to your homepage, then go to the About Us, and then maybe go to the Career page. So basically at times you would see a site having a small text saying Home, About Us, and Career pages with small text on the left on top. So those are sitemaps again. Adding them again helps search engine bots to show your website in a better way. Canonical issues. Now, how many of us here know about what are canonical issues? Raise of hands. Okay, thank you. So, what do I mean by canonical issue? So, if at all your website is abc.com, but your website can also be accessed by http://abc.com, right? And again by www.abc.com. So for a search engine, all these three links leads to your own website, right? That is only one website. But for a search engine, it considers three different websites for just one website. So if at all you have a page or a post which has really good links, text, images, good information, the ratings of this site will go down because search engine considers three websites. So one website is divided into three. So that is not really great for your site in itself for search terms. What you could do is make sure all these URLs are combined together, and that can be done, and we'll be covering a little bit of that later on. Then comes duplicate content as well. So always make sure you write different content always on your site. Posts, pages, make sure you do not copy same content again and again on your site, because search engines do check that, and if they do find copied content, repeated content, the ratings goes low. Okay? And Google Webmaster Dashboard. So this is a tool that can help your website to perform well in SEO. Okay? Okay, so a few things to know about SEO are, one is the website owner, and another would be a marketeer. Not always these two would be different, but it should be different in my perspective, because as an owner, I can write the content, I can make my site on my own, but in terms of marketing it, can be different. So marketer will take care of your SEO as well as, you know, at times designing this website as well, adding the correct meta tags or those terms. So those are different aspects. For an SEO, things always keep on changing, so nothing is fixed. SEO, basically what it does is, for every search engine, they have different algorithms. So Google would have its own algorithm, Yahoo will be having its own, Bing would be having its own, and things do keep on changing on their end as well. So it's not a fixed formula that you can set on your website and you'll be through. It won't be ever. So you need to change according to how they keep on changing. And a lot of times, users do come to us saying, Google has blocked my site. It's not showing the search results. Google is coming to take my site down. They have reported errors and XYZ things. One thing to make sure, Google is not out there to take you. It's there to help your website to be shown. All right? So, it's not that Google is going through each and every site. It has millions of sites to show. It's not checking your site, like, is this abc.com showing multiple duplicate content or having wrong links? It's not checking that. It's looking for good things on your website. Also, Google is there for the visitors and not for the site owners, to be very specific. It helps the end users to show the results what they are checking for. Okay. As for WordPress is built in such a way that it is already SEO ready. SEOs do know the structure how WordPress is built, generally. So you do not have to work very hard in terms of making your website SEO friendly to make sure your site ranks high and has the perfect links and all those things. WordPress helps you do that. It also has XML as well as robot.txt files already included in your WordPress. Those two files help your SEO ratings to be better, okay? And again, WordPress includes titles, so you could add the terms in your title in such a way that they are search friendly, as well as the meta, which is the description that you write in your blog, is again, the structure is known by the SEO. So it basically helps to show your website in a good way. But nothing is perfect, right? So what you could do to check how your website shows on a search engine is go to site:, and add your domain name. What it will show is the cached snippet. So whenever, as well as it will show the index category archives and author pages and canonical issues, how it will be shown. So if you go to site:, I've taken example.com, and if you click on the small arrow that you see down there, just next to the example.com, you can see the cached version of your website. Yeah, how many of us have seen this? Okay. All right, so this will help you to see what exactly the content is shown when your website is listed on a search engine. Okay, and this is how, so basically if I go to there and go to the cached version, this is how it will show me the description of my website. That is called the metadata, meta description of your website. This way, you could see that, and you could change that using different SEO tools and make sure it has the terms that you're actually looking for. So if at all my website is about football, I would make sure the metadata, meta description, has the terms football or all the terms that my website is all about. Okay? Okay, so what tools can help you out? Google Webmaster Tool is the go-to tool I would suggest in these terms. It helps you with the search terms. So what I mean by search terms. So if at all your website is about football again, let's say, and you are based in Spain, of course, and you would want your public or the visitors coming from your own region, right? So you will make sure to search for the terms that usually people use to search for similar websites. So if at all you go to this tool and search for terms like football, Spain, or such similar terms that your website is about, you will see the websites that are listing with those search terms. And using that, you can use those websites as a guidance, like what is exactly their website writing about, or even the terms that they're using, to include that on your own website. Make sense? Cool. Again, it will also help this tool, Google Webmaster Tool, will help with the crawl errors. So if at all you add your domain name on this tool, it will show what kind of errors are being thrown on your website in terms of search engine. It will help with HTML suggestion as well. So if at all you're using, so if a post, say, has headings and you have not added the H2 or H3 tags in those, it will suggest those. So again, these titles, these heading tags will help the search engines to show your website in a better way. So those are the few suggestions that this tool will show. It will also help with how to add sitemaps or index pages or link backs as well. A few tips. Always make sure to add your business address to your website. What it would do is help the search engines to show where you are based and show the website for that particular region as well. So if at all you only have it on one page, like say contact us page or about us page, you should probably add that probably in the footer of all the pages, so that all the pages of your website have this info and can be crawled in a better way. Another thing that can help is adding forms. It is always better for a visitor on your website to contact you, right? So that you can have a communication with them to make sure what is happening, to solve their queries if they have any. So having forms is a good way for your visitors as well as for your search engine optimization as well. Okay? And that's it. Thank you so much. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask. Thank you.
Hey, thank you for your talk. I have a question about, you know, there is a tool in Google Tools, I can't remember the name, but you can set your website to be targeted to a given country, right? And in our case, sometimes we need this country to be not just Spain, but all the Spanish language countries. So mainly Spain and those in Latin America. And I've never been able to add this. I don't know if this could be done, if you know.
As far as I understand, it can be done. So what you do is you have your website language set as Spanish. So that would actually help search engines to show your website for the terms, for the regions where the person is from. So if a person is from Spain, search engine will make sure to show the websites in his own language rather than using English as a general language. Again, there are tools within Google itself. I'm not exactly sure where to guide you right now, but there are tools which can help your website to show for a regional language higher than in English. So if at all you also have multilingual website, so you have English as well as Spanish or French on your website, again, search engine tools do help you out to show your website for each of these languages differently. Answers your question? Cool.
Nadie más? No, alguna pregunta más?
Hi.
Hi.
I would like to ask you, what do you mean, or what kind of forms do you mean we should add on the website in regards to user experience or usability or?
I would suggest a contact form here.
A contact form?
Yeah. Yeah, because that way, yeah. Oops. Okay, so that way, the visitor of your website can contact you back. So if at all it's a rating form, it will just let them to rate your website or that particular page, but not contact you, basically, right? So if you have a contact form here, it will let you let your visitor contact you, as well as the search engine prefers having a contact form rather than ratings or one-way form, basically.
So you mean that also to get their email address on this kind of
yeah,
thing?
So you can have contact forms in a different ways. Like there are even plugins which let you add huge contact forms as well as just a few fields like your name, your message or whatever. That's it. You could even have that much and that could help.
Okay. ¿Alguien más?
Cool. Thank you so much for listening.